What's up? It's your boy Edward Esco back with Commas and Culture with another video. It's been a while, been on a little hiatus. I've been focusing more so on trading and kind of mulling over the idea of what type of content I want to do for the next video. But this video I'm going to do for the newbies out there. I know I have a video I did a couple months back, Forex for Noobs. That covered a few stuff, but we're going to dial it back even more basic and go through the fundamentals of what Forex is. What are the things you need to look at and how to read certain basic things in the Forex market. I know a lot of you guys are, especially with the new wave of cryptocurrency and the internet, everybody, is posting stuff about trading, stocks, crypto, Forex. There's even multi-level marketing companies about it now. So we're in the age of the you and me investor. It's a rough game. A lot of people are gonna, get sucked into traps, both externally and internally. Whether it is going through the learning curve and the aches of the pains of, making money or losing money due to lack of knowledge, due to lack of education, and more importantly, lack of discipline. So I'm hoping I could drop some free gems for you guys today, show you guys how to, get a basic understanding, see if this is something you want to do and implement in your side hustle, or if you want to make it a full-time hustle. The whole idea of this page, Commas and Culture, is to focus on financial embetterment. We're going to talk about other subjects soon, eventually, but financial embetterment in terms of, being able to be your own boss, being able to generate your own income so you can influence your culture, your lifestyle, the way you live, the way you, the way you feel. So without further ado, I'm not going to make this intro too long. Make sure you like and subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, _Edward_Esco, and let's get it.
Again with another episode. I'm going to show you guys, a little bit more basic information today, kind of get you guys acclimated to Forex trading. Let me just get the camera right here. Now, as I said before, the Forex market stands for the foreign exchange market. This is just like another asset class of investing and trading. As you guys probably know, there's different asset classes. You got stocks, options, cryptos, commodities, different instruments you can use to invest in the appreciation or depreciation of a given asset. The Forex market, because you're dealing with the values of currency, which change constantly all day, 365. It's a $1 trillion market, so it's much easier to take advantage on both sides of the sword, both on increases and decreases of prices. So what are we looking at in the currency market? We're not looking at stocks. We're not buying percentages or shares of a company. Instead, we're buying pretty much a percentage of the value of a currency in one in relation to another currency. So when I say in relation to another currency, currency is trade in cross pairs. If you look at my screen here, we are looking at the Great British Pound, US Dollar, GBP, USD, right? So the first currency you have here is going to be your base. The second one is going to be your quote. The base one, think of it like a ratio. It's like 1:2, you see these numbers here. This is your base, your main currency, and you're comparing it to the value of yen. So one Great British Pound is equivalent to 167.70 worth of yen. So you have the base and the quote. The one that you're buying or selling is always the base. So looking at GBP USD, if I wanted to look for a buying opportunity, well, it's selling off right now. Who knows what this thing is going to do? It's been all over the place, but I would buy the pound, and technically I would be selling USD, because as this goes up, as you look at this price chart here, this with the X and Y axis, on this axis here, it shows the prices. So right now it's at 1.253. If it went up to 1.240, that's more US dollars that the pound can buy. It's going to be 1.25 400. So that's the first thing. Currency is trade in cross pairs. You have the base and the quote. So I'm going to write that down for you guys. I'm not much of a writer, so I'm just going to make a note here. Base. That's not what I actually wanted. Let me just get rid of that. Where is it? Where's the brush? I never use the brush, so excuse me if I take a minute to find this shit. All right, so we have G B. Oh man, I'm really bad at this, guys. I apologize. USD. Oh man, this is horrible. I'm trying to use this like this new stylus thing, and it's not really working out. But so you got your base. Yeah, this is probably gonna take me forever to do this video, like if I continue to do this, but I'm gonna have to like just write one of these because so this is your base, and then you got your quote, right? So you're always, again, when you're trading, the base currency is what's most important. You're buying and selling the strength of this currency, the base. So when you're reading price, let's just get rid of this. When you're trying to determine the price of a currency cross pair, or trying to read one of these, what's called price charts here, the measurement readings, the value is as a visual, whoops, is visually represented on the chart as what's called candlesticks. These bars here are candlesticks. You can also trade it as a line chart, and there's different type of candlesticks. These are just standard Japanese candlesticks. Why they're called Japanese candlesticks, you can find another video on YouTube for that. But what I'm going to show you guys is if we go back over here to this axis over here, you'll see the prices here. So as these candlesticks move in a up or down direction, or bullish or bearish direction, you will notice the price increase here. So the next thing I want to show you guys is what is this price increase called? In the Forex market, it's not called points, except for when you're trading, maybe what's called an index, but I don't want to get too, again, too complicated. It's called pips, percentage in points. So I'm going to show you guys how to count pips. So a pip is the smallest number that moves a pair. It's counted from the fourth move from the decimal, except for pairs that end in JPY. So again, and if you've seen a lot of the pairs that we've talked about, a lot of the pairs that you see, Euro USD, Pound USD, USD JPY, they all have US in it, US dollar, so interest rates. Another thing that affects it that comes out monthly are employment numbers. Employment. If more people are getting employed, the economy is doing better, more people can pay their bills, more people can consume, less default on loans, things of that nature. All these things affect the dollar, affect the strength of different international currencies. The next thing that can affect it is politics, political news. Who's getting elected? what are their belief systems, politics. Wow, I'm really good at this. Hold on. And the next thing I want to go for or talk about, which we've pretty much been talking about, is technical analysis. Ooh, look, and we would have caught those buys if we got in at 35. You know, that's 10 pips right there. So we had 1.25, it's at 1.2545. But the last thing, you know, these are some of the main things you want to focus on. I mean, you don't want to get more complicated than that in terms of looking at factors, because there's all subcategories within, you know, within these four topics: interests, employment, politics. First of all these fall underneath fundamental. There's really only two types of methods of looking at the market: fundamental and technical. You know, technical is the physical tools you're going to use to try to speculate and guess where price is. You know, you got your, you know, your trend lines, you got your support. All right, guys, so as you see, as we've been talking, nice limit order hit. Yeah, right on that. Yeah, we're going to get this while we're podcasting. So how do we calculate wins and losses based on pip count? I'm going to show an example based on the trade I just took, actually. We got in at 1.2544, and the low, the current low, it's about to go lower, but 1.2528. That's a difference of 15 pips. So how does that translate into dollars? Well, the broker will give you different units to trade with, to make money and to speculate with, to basically take advantage of these price movements. Now, these units are called lots. We have the infamous micro lot. We have the mini. And we have the standard. Standard lot. So a standard lot is represented as one standard is 1.00, a mini is 1.10, and micro is 0.01. Now, the broker allows you to take positions on something what's called leverage, and leverage pretty much allows you to buy a percentage of the value of the said currency at 0.01%. Now, the value of these currencies at 0.01, hold on 1 second. All right, sorry, just had to take a look at this real quick, make sure my stops are in a good area, just to make sure I don't ooze out too much money trying to trade and do this podcast here, which probably isn't a good idea, and I don't recommend it for you guys at home. Don't multitask trading ever. You know, we didn't do anything too heavy or too risky, but we do have some positions now. We were in profit, now we're break even, but anyway, so we have the micro, mini, and standard. Now, a standard lot is equivalent to $100,000 worth of value of currency, 100K. Now you might be asking, how is it that you can put in a standard and be able to buy 100K? Because a standard is actually valued at 0.01% of the equivalent value. So 100K, this standard lot is actually valued at, you know, 100K at 0.01%. So this is 100K, standard is going to be 100K, this is going to be 10K, and this is going to be 1K. So depending on what type of position you take, micro, mini, or standard, you're buying $100,000, $10,000, or $1,000 worth of value equivalent to this at 0.01%. So 0.01% of 100K is $10. So that means for every pip, it's $10. Pip. Same thing with this. With the mini, for every mini position you do, for every pip is $1. $1. And this is gonna be 10 cent. So a lot of you guys that are new, you gotta scale up. Start with the micro, trade the positions at 10 cents a position. You'd be surprised. You could put on like a 0.08. I've used micro lots on some positions like gold and made $300 in a day. I remember when I was coming up trading smaller accounts, I would trade 0.03s on gold and make like $300, $200, you know what I'm saying, in a whole day trading that. So it really depends what you're trading. Certain currencies move more than others, so it might be easier to trade a micro lot, or less daunting to trade a micro lot on a currency or a asset class that moves faster. So hopefully you guys understand what lot sizes are and how the broker is able to give you leverage to take advantage of these positions in the forex market. Now, the last thing I just want to go over, I pretty much went over everything I wanted to go in the video. I just want to basically tell you guys that, these are just the basics. There's a lot more, stuff to learn in the market. Once you've learned how to read a price chart, then you're able to try to get in and see how you can best exploit the market. But the first thing is figuring out what you're comfortable with, what your risk tolerance is, what your strategy is, and both offensive and defensive. And then the most important thing is sticking to it. That's the hardest thing, the psychological factor of being able to, you're in a market where money can be made so fast, but at the same time, if you're not disciplined, if you don't, pay attention to these parameters you put in place for yourself, then, it's not going to make sense and it's not going to be a good time. So, I didn't want to make this video too long. I hope it was informative and you guys got a nice summary as to what the forex market is, how to calculate wins and losses in the forex market, count pips. And yeah, I hope to see you guys next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you on the next video. Peace.
Stepping stones to a new level. Progress bring new devils. Hard headed, way too stubborn. Dashboard say too something. Where I'm from, you gotta shoot some. Wartime every few summers. Front line if you a newcomer. Going crazy just to prove something. Word is that them smokes coming. Get low and go do something. Fed case for your crew, youngin'. Dip down and just scoop something.